everybody. Dr. Fuck here with the top 10 of 1977. In case you missed it, this is part two. I put up part one yesterday. So let's get into it. So at number 10, again, I'm having problems finding some albums. I think, I don't know, maybe I lost them in moves or whatever. So I couldn't find it, so fuck it. I just grabbed the deluxe box set I bought a year or so ago. Farewell to Kings by Rush. Amazing album at number 10. Xanadu, my favorite Cygnus. The title track, Closer to the Heart, is the popular one on here. Love Cinderella Man and Mandragal, whatever it's called. Now, that one I'm not too fond of. That one's okay. It's not bad, but the rest of the album's fucking awesome. Love it, and this box set is fucking epic. Brings a lot of extras, as you know. All right, number 9, total game changer. And I said before, talking about the Ramones, that I'm not a big punk rock fan, but this one, I'm a big fan. I guess I'm a punk rock poser, because I only like the popular bands. Never Mind the Bollocks at number 9. This album is amazing, beginning to end, man. Bodies, Holiday in the Sun, 7, every song, every fucking song. Favorite song on here is probably Pretty Vacant. This is the Picture Disc Record Store Day 1. I do have the original one. I've never played this one. And I don't know, while I was going through my albums, I saw this. I go, oh yeah, this is 77. I love this album. And I didn't get into this in 77, obviously. I was a little kid, you know. And I don't think this was, I mean, they were more hype than, you know, they were never on the radio. I discovered this album well into the 80s. And you know, I knew God Save the Queen of Anarchy, but one of my favorite albums of all time. And they only made one album, and it's an epic album, and I don't think Rock and Roll Swindle and whatever the fuck else counts, even though I like a lot of Rock and Roll Swindle. I own that on vinyl, too. But, yeah, definitely deserves to be in my top 10. I love this fucking album, and I think Johnny Rotten, Lydon, is one of my heroes. I am addicted to watching interviews of that guy on YouTube. He's a straight shooter. He doesn't fucking give a fuck what anybody thinks. Talks from the fucking heart. Love him. All right. Number 8. No, wait. Yeah, here we go. Number 8. Yeah, okay. I was going to switch this. Man, it's almost tied with number 7. Foghat Live. Fuck yeah. One of the greatest live albums. Home in My Hand. Wow, what a great song. Fool for the City, I Just Want to Make Love to You, is an epic live recording. Road Fever, Honey Hush, which is pretty much Train Kept Rolling, and Slow Ride. Such a great fucking album, and had to make my top 10. It just had to. I cannot leave this off the top 10. Foghat Live, a must have if you like it. You like your 70s hard rock. All right, at number 7, my favorite Styx album, The Grand Illusion. Probably favorite track on here is Man in the Wilderness, but Miss America rocks. Title track, you know, Fooling Yourself, everybody knows. I love Superstars. That's such a great melodic song from Tommy Shaw, and everybody knows Come Sail Away. What else is on here? Castle Walls. Wow, man, that may be my second favorite. And the Grand Finale, which is pretty much Grand Illusion reprise, the short version. This is awesome. And I have the poster. The poster looks like that, so I don't have to take it out. This I've had forever. This one I believe I bought in 1977 because I love it so much. And I still love it. I'm a huge Styx fan. And you know, critics panned all this shit. Corporate rock, fuck you. I'll take this shit over Velvet Underground any day. Yeah, fuck Lou Reed. Rest in peace. Don't mean to make fun of the guy because he's dead. But I can't get into that artsy fartsy. Come on, babe. Take a walk in the wild. So, and the color girls say, shoop, doop, doop. Get the fuck out of here with that bullshit. All right. At number 6, my favorite album from Queen, News of the World. Amazing fucking album. Definitely had to make the top 10. Of course, We Will Rock You. We Are Champions. All Sheer Heart Attack. It's fucking awesome. Roger Taylor going all punk rock and shit. And All Dead. Great Brian May. Spread Your Wings, one of my favorite Queen ballads. This whole fucking album, man. Get Down, Make Love. Sleeping on the Sidewalk, I really like. I can't read this shit. This text is like really funny looking. It's Late. I love this whole album. It's fucking Who Needs You. Great. Great fucking album. Amazing artwork. I love this artwork. It's so cool. And then like the monster robot reaching in. Fucking awesome. My favorite Queen album right here. And I need to get that deluxe version. Still don't have it. Number 5. Sin After Sin, Judas Priest. The first album on Columbia Records with Simon Phillip on drums. He only played on the album. He didn't join the band. Studio musician. Sinner. Descendant Aggressor. Diamonds and Rust. Stargazer. Let Us Pray. One of the first songs with a double bass. Last Rose of Summer. Beautiful fucking ballad. I love this. Here Comes the Tears. Call for the Priest. Raw Deal. Beginning and end. This is fucking classic. My favorite Priest is 70s Priest. This motherfucker deserves to be in the top 10. And they are like my third favorite band of all time. So, of course, I'm going to put Priest all the way on top, especially in the 70s. All right. At number 4. For a long time, Pink Floyd Animals was my favorite Pink Floyd album. For the longest time. But then it got overshadowed by The Wall. Man, how can you not love Dogs? Not only the animal, but the song. Sheep, too. No, Sheep. And Pigs on the Wing, of course. And Pigs, three different ones. Let There Be Rock. Probably the most pissed off AC/DC album. Fucking Dog Eat Dog. The title track, Bad Boy Boogie. On the day I was born, the rain fell down. There was trouble brewing in my hometown. Bond was the best. Overdose. This one has Crap City in Blue. This version. So what's missing from my version? I think it's Problem Child, which was the American version. Hell Ain't a Bad Place to Be and a Whole Lot of Rosie. Beginning to end, go down. This fucking rocks. And I brought out the CD too. This is the Australian cover of it from this box set I have of all the Australian CDs. Fuck yeah, number 2. Now, number 1 is tied. It's tied, and this band is so special to me that I dedicated a whole channel to them. So and they released 2 albums in 1977, their first and second album. Cheap Trick. I have to put these tied. Even though if you put a bullet to my head, I'll put this one above this one, because if I want you to want me, shitty studio version, but this one's more pissed off. And in case I did do 10, this will be number 2 and number 1. I don't know. I know I'm fucking up here. But whatever. Classics. These are my favorite albums of 1977. And this is the first one I heard. And I told this story before, but I'll say it again because it's so interesting. If anybody remembers Columbia House, where you would order records and you never pay them, my buddy was a member of it, and he made me a member so he can get a free album or so. So I gave him a list of what I had, and he made a mistake and got this one in color instead of another one I wanted. And then when it came, for the longest time, it was a cassette. I never played it because this album cover reminds me of, like, the Beach Boys. I thought this was, like, you know, I don't know, like, so, you know, a duet of two guys. Because I don't believe it had this on the cassette. It only had this picture. So I never played it. And then one day, I was going to erase it. And before I did, because they were playing something on the King Biscuit Flower Hour, and I was going to tape over it, and my friend said, dude, put it on, let's hear how it sounds. I was like, okay. And I put it on, and the first song, Hello There, dun, 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 and that riff came on, and I was like, what the fuck? Made me a fanatic. I am a fanatic of Cheap Trick. Huge, huge fan. First concert I ever went to was a Cheap Trick show. This one's my favorite, but man, this one, it's number 2. Number 2. Let's just say, if I did 11, then whatever. What was it? Whatever was number 10, put it at 11. My favorite albums of 1977. Thanks for watching, guys. And I'm going to work on 1978. As you know, I'm putting one up a month. So I hope you're enjoying this little series I'm doing. I don't know how many years I'm going to go. I just can't see myself do the 90s. Not that I hate the 90s music. I just think it was so all over the place that we'll see when we get there, but I'll definitely go through the 80s, hopefully up to 89. Who knows? But thank you so much for watching. And we're still in the 70s, dude. All right on. Kiss my grits. Later.